Good morning, my dear students. Today we will study our chapter number 4, metals and non-metals. As in our previous chapters, we have studied about the matter and the substances. The substances are made up of matters. Matter is anything that occupies space and have mass are known as matters. Matters have three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous. Actually, we can classify the matter into two categories: metals and non-metals. Now, in this chapter, we will study about the metals and non-metals. First of all, we will distinguish the metals and non-metals on the basis of their physical properties. First of all, I have given here the table about their physical properties. The first property of the substances is hardness. Metals are generally hard in nature. They are generally hard in nature, except sodium and potassium, since they can easily cut with the help of a knife, so they are soft in nature. Non-metals are soft in nature. Next, the appearance. The metals are lustrous in appearance, means they are shiny in appearance. Shiny in appearance. Whereas non-metals are dull in appearance. For example, if you observe gold or silver, gold and silver are the example of metals. They look very shiny, lustrous. So generally the metals are shiny in appearance, whereas the non-metals such as coal, sulfur, oxygen, etc., they are dull in appearance because they do not appear shiny or lustrous. Next, the sonorous. When we struck our metal sheets or metal substances, we can hear the sound. Actually, when we struck the metal substances, it produces a sound, and this property is known as sonority. So, metals are generally sonorous in nature. Whereas, non-metals are non-sonorous. That's why the bells are being made by the metals, not by non-metals, since metals are sonorous in nature. Next, the malleability. Malleability is the property in which we can beat the substances into a thin sheets, means by beating we can convert the substance into a sheets, and that property is known as malleability. Generally, metals can be beaten easily into the sheets, so they are malleable in nature, whereas non-metals does not can be beaten into the sheets, so they are non-malleable in nature. So metals are malleable in nature, whereas non-metals are non-malleable. If we want to draw a coal into a sheets, when we beat, it will break down into a very fine particles, but it cannot be spread into the sheet. So it is non-malleable. Next, the ductility. Ductility is the another property in which the substance can be drawn into a thin long wires, and that property is known as ductility. Generally, when we stretch the metal, the metallic substance can be drawn into a thin long wires, whereas non-metals cannot be drawn into thin long wires. So non-metals are non-ductile, whereas metals are ductile in nature. Next, the conductivity. On heating the metallic substances, we can observe on touching the metal substance becomes hot, whereas non-metals does not becomes hot since the metals conduct heat, whereas non-metal does not heat. That's why the metals becomes hot, whereas non-metal does not become hot on heating. Next, when we connect the metal substance with a wire, with the help of the tester, we can observe that these substances can conduct the electricity. As we connect or touches the wire to the metal or the tester to the metal, we can observe the bulb will glow in the substances, metallic substances, that shows that the metallic substance conduct electricity, whereas if we connect any non-metal such as wood or coal with the wire and then check it by connecting the tester, we can observe that there will be no bulb glow in the tester. That shows that the non-metals does not conduct electricity, means they are poor conductor of electricity. But there is an exception. In cases of graphite is a non-metal made up of carbon. It is a carbon form, but the graphite is the only exception that it can conduct electricity. We can perform an activity, we can sharp both the ends of the pencil, and both the ends of the pencil can be connected with the help of the wire. Now, with the help of the tester, you can check. While checking, we will see that the bulb will glow. It shows that graphite conducts electricity. That means graphite is the only non-metal which can conduct electricity. So the conductivity, good conductor of metals, are good conductor of heat and electricity. Whereas non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Except graphite, since it conducts electricity. So these are the properties on the basis of which we can differentiate metals and non-metals. Now another property is also there. Metals are generally solid in nature. The seventh property, state. Metals are generally solid in nature except mercury. Except mercury. Mercury exists in liquid form at room temperature, whereas non-metals, they exist in all the three forms . For example, bromine is liquid in state, the oxygen, nitrogen, etc., they are gases in state, and coal, the carbons, that is coal, diamond and graphite, that are solid in nature. So we can say that the non-metals can exist in all the three states, whereas metals are generally solid in nature. Exception is there, mercury. Mercury is liquid at room temperature. I hope you are able to understand. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home and stay safe.